Hello, my name is Jean-Michel Arnal. I'm an anesthesiologist. I work in ICU. I want to welcome you in this hospital, and now I'm going to show you something very interesting. This patient is 69 years old. He was admitted for a septic shock after a complicated abdominal surgery. Now he's stabilized, so we stop sedation and he's recovering spontaneous activity. ASV is a closed-loop mode of ventilation in which the user set the target minute volume and the ventilator will determine the combination of tidal volume and respiratory rate according to the respiratory mechanics. So the ventilator measures the respiratory mechanics using a proximal flow sensor, and namely, it measures the expiratory time constant. The expiratory time constant is a mix of the static compliance and the respiratory resistances. So with one number, we have an assessment of the full respiratory mechanics of the patient. And it's accurate both in passive and active patients. So this is a panel in ASV where we have to set the target minute volume in terms of percentage of normal minute volume. So the first step is to set the predicted body weight. So we set the gender and the height of the patient, and the ventilator will display the predicted body weight. 100% target minute volume is 100 milliliters per kilogram per minute, which is a normal minute ventilation. Of course, if the patient has a diseased lung, we need a higher minute volume to reach a normal PaCO2. In ASV, the oxygenation parameter, PEEP and FiO2, are manually set. And then if we go in the setting, we also have to set the maximum pressure limit and the inspiratory trigger, expiratory trigger, and pressure ramp. So if the patient is passive, ASV is a pressure control mode with an automatic adjustment of the pressure control to reach the target tidal volume. And the ventilator delivers a mandatory respiratory rate to target the calculated, the optimal respiratory rate. If the patient is active, it will switch automatically to a pressure support mode with an automatic adjustment of pressure support to reach the target tidal volume. In this case, the respiratory rate is controlled by the patient and no more by the ventilator. So on this panel, we will see, for example, what are the targets for this patient. Here we set 130% of target minute volume, which is 9.6 liters per minute. These are on the green line. This is respiratory rate on X and tidal volume on the Y axis. And the green line are all the combination to reach 9.6 liters per minute. So we could do very high respiratory rate and very low tidal volume, or reversely, very high tidal volume, very low respiratory rate. Actually, the target for this patient is 14 of respiratory rate and around 600 of tidal volume. So the target is this red circle, and the patient is the yellow cross, so the ventilator will drive the patient to the target. On this panel, we can assess the respiratory mechanics by these pictures showing the static compliance of the patient and the inspiratory resistances. We see the diaphragm that show that the patient is actually active. On the top of the screen, we see the pressure and flow waveforms, which are also very useful to assess the patient-ventilator synchrony. When we want to win with ASV, what we have to check is what is the pressure support used actually for the patient. So actually, with the target minute volume of 130%, The pressure support is 24 minus 7, so 17. So we can start to wean the patient by decreasing the target minute volume, usually 20 by 20. And in this way, the pressure support will decrease. If the patient is still fine, at some point when the pressure support is below 16 centimeters of water, then we may go to a spontaneous breathing trial. The spontaneous breathing trial can be done either in pressure support or even in ASV. In this case, for the spontaneous breathing trial, we decrease the target minute volume to the minimum, which is 25%, and we decrease PEEP to 5, for example, and we are very careful to monitor the patient. If after half an hour the patient is still fine, not in respiratory distress, we have to consider extubation.